Oh, there's a plane! Holy crap! Oh my god, there's a plane flying overhead right now. Flare gun! Flare gun! Where's the flare gun? What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Subgator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things, playing Stranded Deep. And you know what's really weird that has happened? So there are three potato plants on this island. Now, this is our island. This is our big, humongous, ginormous house that we're building. And this is our island right here. And I've been collecting stuff and things. We'll talk about that in a second. But I'm pretty sure there was only ever one potato plant here. And this is it right here. This is the only one I ever saw. And then all of a sudden now, there's another potato plant here. And there was another potato plant over there that I saw. So we're in the potatoes, man. You know, I was thinking for a little bit about this game, and I was thinking about, like, survival, how long you could survive. I was thinking a little bit about, like, you know, like, could you survive forever? How long could it go for? How long can we survive on the island? How long can we live? It's raining. It's perfect. Oh, there's a plane! Holy crap! Oh my god, there's a plane flying overhead right now. Flare gun! Flare gun! Where's the flare gun? No, plane! Flare! See the flare? Come get me! Save me! Are you gonna turn around? Where could you land? How is it even possible that you would see it? Maybe you saw the flare? And I think our flare gun's out of flare. I think we're just done. There's nothing I can do with it now. Yeah, I can shoot it. So our flare gun is out of juice, but we used it for a very good reason. We have, I think, flares around somewhere. We fired a flare at the plane. Oh my god. So, alright, yeah, a couple things I've been thinking about. Well, we'll save this for later. It's so sucky that it's raining. Anyway, alright, let's do this instead. Let me tell you, it'll be a rainy day on the island. I've been collecting some sticks. How many sticks, you ask? Watch the frame rate when I drop these sticks. As it's updating all the movement of all the other sticks. Let's try a palm frond. If we grab a few. Oh, baby. It goes down to like 7 frames while it's updating that. So anyway, we got a huge amount of stuff and things. I might wait for it to be day so we can continue. But today we're going to be getting some building done. I'm really excited about it. I've been going around to some of the other islands. We're going to talk about that too. But yeah, I'm going to wait for it to be nice. This kind of stinks. Better. We kind of can't have that happy island music on while we're... while it's raining. That doesn't work. All right, so let's get our crude hammer. Holy crap. And let's start taking a look at... I want to get 3 more foundations made. So I think we should have enough stuff and things to do all that. So we get another foundation, and I want to put them back here so we can kind of build onto our house. So let's take a walk. Let's hope this one. Oh, yes. Sweet. All right. So this is going to work out, I think. Now, I'm not sure if we have... I mean, we have a lot of resources here, but you can eat them up really fast. So I'm not really sure how much we're going to be able to get done. I spent about 2 hours, I think. 2.5 hours getting the resources together so we could do something. And my plan was that we would be able to just build and build and build, and it would be the most amazing that ever happened. But I'm not sure if I planned my plan correctly. Is that another plane? Now I'm looking for planes everywhere. There's another plane! Oh, no, wait. That's just the plane jet trail. Well, there it is. No, there is a plane right there. But I don't know. All right. Jeez, I'm criny crow. I didn't even know that that was a thing. You know what? Now I'm thinking about those buoys. We have those buoys. Where the hell is that little flare I found? Here's my flare gun. Is it empty now? Okay, yeah, it's still empty. I had a flare. Probably got washed away in the storm. Stupid storm. Train of thought gone. I can't remember what I was going to talk about now. I was so excited by the plane. How many do I have? There we go. Let's put some posts up or over here. So we'll just squirt all these down over here. So I think originally I was talking about how long I think you could survive. Yeah, we can do a support now. So we can do a support here. And I think you could pretty much survive indefinitely. Like, as long as you had a bucket and you found some potato plants, like, there is no amount of time that you could, like, you know what I mean? You could just go on forever and ever. So, but can you get rescued? That's the thing, and I'm not sure. Emergency mute. Crap. Excuse me. Emergency mute. I apologize for the emergency mute. I'm sorry. All right, let's keep going. So, yeah, I don't know if you could survive, like, forever or what the deal would be. So, I'm not sure if we want any other supports here. I guess on this wall, we would have some walls. I think we would need now two more sticks for supports. Then we're going to actually start bringing some of the stuff over, I think. Because it's not going to let me build it unless I'm on the foundation, I do believe. Because we're going to start getting into the walls and stuff and things like that. So let's go ahead and get our hammer out. Do a couple more supports. One there. And one there. This is going to be like the most epic of the epic houses. I think this is going to be sweet. Oh crap, we need to move materials. Look, it's coming, it's taking shape. We can have a walkway right here in the back, and this is going to be our covered front porch. A couple of you guys mentioned that maybe we should put some foundations in the water and put them really low and make it like a dock. That's definitely something I'm interested in doing. I want to try it out for sure. Oh, I love that. But I want to make sure we have enough items for building the stuff and things today. So, yeah. All right, I got to get some stuff and things moved over there, and I'll BRBs. And we're back. Look at this, guys. So we still got a lot of palm fronds. We still got a good amount of sticks, but isn't that crazy how much we used already? I mean, I've moved some stuff and things around. So, all right. So check it out. Here, we're going to go ahead and... Oh, wait. It's not giving me the... Can I have the special thing? Sweet. We're going to do steps right here. Nope, not there, buddy. There you go. Oh, now we got our back steps on, man. And this is going to be our first wall. So here, we're going to go ahead and make our first wall. Let's see how this works. Oh. Yes, so it's so cool. So let's put a wall up right over here. Now, I don't know how the roof thing is going to work. We'll see. I don't know how many walls we're going to get up either. Get a wall over here like this. Oh, look at this, man. We are constructing an epic. This is going to be so epic. Another wall here. I didn't count, so I'm not sure if I got the right amount or what. It looks like I did. It looks like I got exactly the right amount. We'll get a wall here. Oh, look at that. Super lucky. And we'll get a wall there. All right. So each wall takes 4 sticks and 2 palm fronds. Now I did want to go ahead and make a couple of the ceiling pieces here too. So those are going to be, what is it, 4 sticks and 4 palm fronds? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh my god, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It would be sweet if your trees regrew, even if it took a long time. Because, yeah, this, it takes a lot. You have to do a lot of gathering to do this stuff, man. It takes a lot of off-camera work. This is cool. Like, it's fun, but... Oh, yeah, there was something else that I saw that I wanted to tell you guys about while we're doing this. I saw Marlin. Like, I didn't have my recording software up, and I saw it so quickly. Maybe it was a mirage. I don't know. But I was going over to the other island. The islands that I've been going to, I've been trying to pick ones that are really easy. So one of the ones I've been going to is the island that is to the east, I think. Yeah, that one right there. Basically directly to the east. And then I was like, I'll pick another easy direction. So I started going to the island to the north. That's the original island that we landed on. And then that's the island that where I saw the Marlin. And I was way out in the water. And like I said, it may have been a mirage. I think it's also funny that the hammer... Well, I guess the hammer has durability. You're hammering, but you have no nails. Yeah, so it's a little funny. All right, roof. Ooh! Yes! So cool! Now, can you do a roof if you don't have 4 supports? Okay, so you can't. So I can't put a roof like here. See? So I'm going to have to put supports in the middle here, which kind of stinks. Oh, look at this. And this is our little roof that goes over to our little stairway. This is like a real house, man, except that it's not and made of thatch. But whatever. Don't even pay attention to that. So we need 3 more walls. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we need, you know what, we can drop our machete off over here because we need to pick up 6 palm fronds for the other 3 walls. Palm fronds. Sounds like a food, like a fancy French food. Would you like the palm fronds? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, let's go ahead and squirt all these guys over in our new house. I don't think we're going to do, I don't know. I don't know if we're going to do a covering on this side too. We might because it would be cool. So, all right, let's drop those guys. Like so. Bam. Hammering. Wall time. Let's do this. Become wall. Oh, amazing. And one right here. And one right here. This is almost like creative mode. This is so rad. Now, yeah, it stinks that we're going to have to do some more supports, but it looks like we're going to have to do 1, 2, 3, 4 supports in order to get the rest of the ceiling done. Look at that, man. Look how, oh my God, we plowed through all of that stuff. That is crazy. So, all right, let's go ahead and go over here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I still have, I got an extra stick. Any planes? No planes. You know what I'm thinking, though? You know what makes sense? There's also those buoys around, right? And so, obviously, those buoys mean that there are boats. And there are boats? Look how many freaking boats there are around here. How can there be this many boats and no, like this many crash boats and no not crash boats? Maybe if I spent a couple days out by a buoy and just hung out by the buoy, then the friggin' sharks would probably bite me. Kevin 2 would come. I don't know. I'm just saying. It almost feels like you could get rescued. All right. Let's do supports. Here and here. And here. Now, we want to roof the entire rest of this thing, but I don't think we have enough resources to do it. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, this is going to be our last roof. 1, 2, 3, 4. We still have a... 7 or whatever, 19, 4 palm fronds left, but yeah, not bad. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh wait, oh that's just the one stick. All right, never mind. Let's go roof, and we'll put it back there like that. So if we could have more than one roof, we need 1, 2. Well, basically 3, 6, 7, 8 more roofs. So, and then that's 8 times, it's 4, so 32 more palm fronds and 32 more sticks. That's a lot. That's a lot more sticks and palm fronds. We got a lot of rocks, though. That's good. We like rocks. Yeah, so I guess it's time to gather more resources for our epic house. I can't wait to stick all of our stuff and things in here, too. You know, I'm thinking maybe we'll put, I don't know if you, can you put a bed inside of here? Because that might be cool. And then we could do maybe like a room, a couple of storage rooms. Look, we have enough space for rooms. You know what I mean? Like we could have a couple of storage rooms and then our bed. It's going to be so cool. All right, yeah. All right, so I'm going to go ahead. What do I got here? I'll squirt this thing down. We don't need that. We don't need our one stick. Put this guy back over here. And then we need a crude action, something like that. And the other thing that's really important, if you're playing straight deep and you're trying to do this kind of stuff and build these like really big, like super big buildings and all that, make sure when you go to your island, whatever island you're on, that you leave a rock, a stick, and a lashing there just in case you run out. Now, when I go back over there, I think I have, you know, I'll bring a machete. We have how many machetes? We got a good amount of machetes. We'll bring one with us. But yeah, make sure you have a stick, a rock, and a lashing. That way you can make crude axe in case you get in trouble. So, all right, time to run the loudest boat ever. Let's go. All right, we're going to go now. We'll be back in a little bit, guys. Oh, my God, what is this? What is this? No way. What are you, thing? What is this? Oh, my God, dead X? Mysterious package? Because why not? What does it say on it? The address says Pacific Ocean, Island Key, 45133, Stranded Deep Survivor Colin, maybe? And it says Fragile. What else is it? Because why not? What are you? Why do you have a plant growing out of you? Oh, what does that say? Huge box. Oh, and there's a little writing on it right there, too. It just says, like, 22HIM77KKS721. It might be a code. Maybe it's telling me how to get home. What happens if we open it? We can't open it. Can we pick it up? We have it! We have the box! We have the mysterious box! Because why not? Why wouldn't you? What are you?
Can I throw you on the ground? Can I pick you up? Can I throw you on the ground and pick you up again?
Open!
What if you throw it up in the air?
Open! I want whatever's inside of you.
Stupid box. It doesn't look like it can be opened. I don't know. Maybe I'm not throwing it with enough throwing forces. Limber up. That was the crappiest throw of all time. I guess we can't throw it, or it's not wanting to be thrown. But we found a mysterious box. What it does, who knows? So I was just cutting down some sticks and doing some stuff and things, and I realized I don't think we ever, like, explore the stuff on this island. So there's another lighter. I mean, we don't really need it. I guess we can pick it up. But I think I saw... You know what? I was watching Corrales play this game, because there's a lot of people playing it. But I watched K playing it. It's really... He's super funny. But he calls the little bubbles fart bubbles. I think I saw some fart bubbles around here. But the thing that I was wondering from his video is if the fart bubbles smell like farts. So we definitely need to find some fart bubbles and smell them and see if that's the case. I thought I saw fart bubbles on this island. Maybe I was mistaken. Maybe they were just regular bubbles. Is there any fart bubbles around here? Give me that back. And we're back on the island. And we've got a lot more resources gathered up. All of our stuff and things are going to be so amazing here in a moment. You watch. Look how organized I am. All this stuff is so organized right here. And we're going to put a roof on our super amazing house. I'm really excited to get this thing done. I think that's how it is with any game where there's like resource gathering. You know, and you spend a lot of time doing something. That's the reward, man. It's like when you get something cool done. You know what I mean? So that's why you gotta kind of, sometimes you gotta put the time in, man. All right, so put all our sticks over there. I think we are gonna put a roof on over here too, but I don't have the resources to do that right now. So let's grab this hammer here and come up here. And all right, here we go. Ready? Roof. The roof. I wonder if this would catch on fire. If it did, it would be super sad, but then we could sing the song. All right, roof. You know what would be also with this game? There's a couple of things with building that I think really kind of stink. One of them is that if you make a mistake, if you accidentally clicked foundation, like there's nothing. Oh, wait, no, you can. Okay, so that's not true. So if you accidentally click something on, if you right click, I do believe, like if I go over here and go like this, it gives you all the pieces back. So that's awesome. But if you build something, there's no way to unbuild it. So once you've built, I have to pick these guys up, you can't unbuild it or move things, which does kind of stink. It would be cool if you could move stuff around. And I mean, it makes sense in like reality that you would be able to. I mean, if you can take all this stuff and take a hammer and build it, you know, it would make sense that you'd be able to take it off as well. So, all right, we got a bunch of stuff and things going in here now. Now, I'm thinking, see, we already have a bed outside. I guess we'll have another bed. I mean, what else can you do but just have two beds then, I guess. So we'll take this. Oh, we can only make a foundation. Oh, wait, we just need to unequip. Yeah, there we go. Oh, campfire. So, oh, man, I think we need some lashings or something that we don't have to make. I can't remember how to make the bed. You know what I'm thinking, though? 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think we need just 8 of these to make another wall. Wall? I think we need just 8 of them to make another wall. And what I'm thinking that we're going to do... Let's see here. Is it 8? No, we can't. I can't. No, crap. Now I can't remember what we need to make a wall. I'm thinking inside of here that what we'd actually do would be to put another wall in here. Or maybe a couple, and have it be like a storage area so we could get some of the stuff moved off the beach. Maybe get some coconut storage going. There's our mysterious package. So, but yeah, and I think it would be really rad. Now, wondering, can we climb up on top of the house? Wow, you can kind of like Spider-Man on here. No way, Spider-Man. Can you climb? I really would love to be able to get up on top of there, but I don't think that it's possible right now. So you can kind of climb the side. The roof is like a solid block. Oh, baby. So as you swim, it kind of makes you swim strangely. What if we just... Okay, if you stop moving, you fall. Swim up, man. Swim in the air. So, and then someone else was saying you can fly in this game. Like, if you grab something and then jump on it. But I think they were meaning more like a boat or something like that. But anywho, all right. So we got a bunch of stuff and things set up here really good. I wish that we knew some better stuff about the crafting mechanics. Exactly how to get that wall in there. I can't remember. I just built them too, but I can't remember exactly what we need. But check this thing out, man. I mean, that is a friggin' epic house. You got to admit, like, that's pretty crazy, right? That's a lot of stuff and things that went into that thing. I think it's really cool. I'm really glad we did it, man. You imagine if you came on a desert island and some guy had built this huge thing, you'd be like, are you sure you want to leave? And I'd be like, I'm not sure I want to go, man. I got all the things I need right here. I got crabs. I got sardines and all this other crap. Garbage thing. Yeah, see, this looks like a beach bum lives here. Some sort of... We need to get way more organized, peeps. And we're back, and the sun is setting. And actually, check the recipes. We need some palm fronds in order to get... And that makes sense, right? I mean, obviously, look at it. The lashings inside of there are made with palm fronds. So we need some more of that in order to get some more walls built. And that's something that we're really running low on. Even on the other islands that I've been going to, you know, you can get a lot of logs from a palm tree, but you can't get a lot of fronds, man. And we got to keep at least one palm tree on our island, right? So, yeah, but I actually just got a phone call, and I got some kind of bad news. So it looks like that today we're going to have to cut the episode a little bit short. So that's going to be it for today, guys. I hope you like Stranded Deep. You know, make sure you guys do me a favor. And if you like the video, show your support by hitting the thumbs up button for me. Feel free to share and favorite it as you see fit. And may the stuff and things be with you. Thumbs up for the house, peeps. That's so cool.